Hello, and thank you for watching Gameplay by Ardubich. This is episode 3 of Trackday Manager by Arctic Hazard Game Studio. In our last two episodes, we raced 4 races, and I sucked in all of them. There's a couple, one I got 5th place, one I got 6th place, but ultimately I made some bad decisions, and it cost me some decent finishes, so we're going to hope to fix that as we get a couple races in today, and I hope you've enjoyed this series so far, and I thank you for watching, so let's get a few races in. Looking on the side here, it looks like we got 3 races in on a 10-ton hammer, got 7 more to go on that, we can start getting some sponsorship money there. Let's see. We're going to go ahead and stick with the soft tires for this track. If this is anything like yesterday, it might start raining halfway through, which I thought was awesome. But we'll see. Looks like there's no players so far. Kind of sucks, but hopefully my video encourages people to buy the game, because I do think it's a fun game, and I think others would think it's fun as well. Especially once you start getting a full field of all players playing. So I will go ahead and throw my hat in and endorse this game. And also, I would like to address the issues with the last couple of videos. I found out that the software I use to record gameplay records at a max of 1920 by 1080, and I've been trying to play it, some games in 4K, some games I've been playing at like, you know, 32 or 28 or whatever, and it just wasn't working with the software that I use. So I went ahead and fixed that for this video. Also, I turned up the recording level for my voice volume. Hopefully that all is solved for this video. All right, we're off. We're starting at 12th place. Nice little drift there to get us through the corner a little easier, but still just don't have enough under the engine. And there was a little bit of a blip there. I'm sure that probably showed up in the video. That was the game, not the video. It happened to me yesterday as well, during the first video. Just for some random reason, we'll just kind of freeze. The race in the background still goes on. And luckily, your performance isn't hampered by any lag, because it's not you that's playing, it's your driver. Zoom out here a little bit. Alright, one lap in, and we've lost one position. So hopefully we can remedy that. It looks like we're already down on another position. Even with the speed boost there, we just didn't have enough. Luckily, some people started overheating, and we got past them. Alright, so looks like the weather's going to be staying the same for the next portion of the race. You do want to make sure you pay attention to the weather, because like I said, the weather will change and it could indicate that rain is coming or cooler or warmer track temperatures. Also, I noticed that you didn't get to see all the video, or like the screen from last time. Like I said, it all got cut off. As you can see, we got on the side here, the positions, we got our little status indicator down here of all of our skills, temperature, miles per hour, and then the little speed boost here. You got the weather down here, your lap times, the map, and then there's a little chat here for when there are players. Again, I apologize for that being cut out. Coming up on halfway in the race here. We're in fifth place, we're doing well. I'm gonna wait, let's see. I wanna pit during the seventh lap, so I'm not sure. I think I'll hit pit after we cross the start finish here, which would make us pit in the seventh lap. And that should give us plenty of fuel to get through the race, I think. We'll see how we're doing on fuel when we get closer to the pit. I'm a gamble. I think we can still get through another lap with the fuel that we have. So we're gonna wait another lap to pit, and that should get us through the rest of the race without having to pit again. Weather's staying steady, so far we don't have to worry about changing tires or anything. I'm actually going to tell them to put hard tires on. I want to get a little more speed. I don't know why my guy just freaked out there and lost like 5 positions, but it probably has something to do with our poor tire condition. So, all right, we're going to head into the pits here. All right, guys, come on, good pit stop, let's go. Ah, that's a slow time. All right, so we're gonna be good the rest of the race. 14th is just try to get up from here. Hopefully some other cars who pit earlier in the race is going to have to pit again. So we should be able to make up some of those spots. just when you tell your guy to overtake and be a little more aggressive. Could have got on the inside there and got past him that turn, but instead he just braked behind everyone else. And it's going to start raining. Well, hopefully the rain holds off long enough for us to get through the rest of the race, because I'm not going to pit. My hope is that everyone else pits and we can get a big enough lead that we can hold them off. There's the rain coming in on the last lap. Looks like a lot of other people aren't pitting either. So, pit strategy did not help us this race. Had a chance to get past the guy that was overheating, but the driver just didn't race aggressive enough. Alright, so looks like we're going to finish ninth in this race. Pit strategies didn't work out. Just hoping to hope to make up a few extra positions at the end when everyone else was pitting, but no one else pit, so it didn't work. The thing that hurts us the most is the fact that we just don't have anything under the hood. Got a little windshield wipers on. Alright, we have another sponsorship offer. Everything's the same as our other sponsorships. Let's see. Win fastest zone medal. So it looks like we still have enough space for one more sponsor after this. and not enough money for an upgrade or skill points for an upgrade either. So let's just jump in another race. Alright, I have not raced this one yet, but I am going to go ahead and say that we're going to want soft tires for this. Still no other players. So it looks like we qualified last place. I'm not sure what the qualifying time is. I don't know if you have to race the track once and then your best lap is your qualifying time or what, because it never gave me a qualifying time there. Big pile up there. So this is definitely a course that you're going to want to be conservative on. Maybe use your speed boost on the straightaway, the start-finish one. It looks like there's a backside one here as well. But as you can tell by the people spinning out, you use your speed boost too much heading into a turn, and you're going to lose it. And apparently, other racers start off with the speed boost and players don't. So one lap takes about 18% of our fuel. Keep that in mind for later. Go ahead and overload in some of these turns here. First place has a heck of a car because they're killing us. We're going to overload here. We'll use our speed boost in this back side here. See how it works out for us. Okay, so going up that hill kills your heat. So that's not a good idea. We're going to want to use it on the front. Oh, that guy just got rocked. It would be interesting to see if they'd put in damage effects. You know, there's obviously collisions in this game, so having damage would add another aspect to it. it may be the option to race conservatively so that you don't risk having damage. Or even the option to race more conservatively because that guy just screwed me over by overheating in front of me and my guy did nothing to get past him. Alright, so we got people pitting already. We'll be good to go to lap 6. I do want to get halfway just because I don't want to pit again at the end of the race and end up losing a bunch of spots. Yeah, we got plenty of fuel to get through that. The only thing I'm worried about is the tires. This is a very technical course, so our tire traction is going to come into play and hurt us a little bit going into that sixth lap. But I think overall, we'll be better off for waiting. Use our speed boost here because we're not going to have the front stretch to use all of it. There we go, got through it all. It looks like stupid idiots overheating in front of us. Cost us another position and even held us up some. A more aware AI would be really nice just to avoid that. But all right, as you can see, our driver is going through turns a lot slower because of the bad tire conditions, so like I said, that would come in to hurt us a little bit. It looks like we're not the only ones pitting here, so not going to make up too many positions, but hopefully people who pit too early will get past a little later. Alright, let's see if we can get a good pit in here. Our best pit was 10 seconds, like 10.8 or something like that. What did we get here? 14, wow. So our crew's actually starting to hurt us more than they are helping us. But at least we won't be needing them anymore this race. Work on breaking back into that top 10. Pushed it a little too much there. So if a developer ends up by chance watching one of these videos, which surprisingly I've had happen before, one major recommendation I would like to make is maybe the division of like classes. Because I mean, if you're just starting out and you get paired up with players who've been playing for a while, you're gonna guaranteed to be finished last place. And then, you know, these are all computer players, and I can barely break through. The only time I can pass anyone is when they screw up or overheat. So to have kind of like a level playing field as far as competition goes, that'd be very helpful. You know, it'd make the races more competitive too, especially once you get into like the higher, you know, higher levels of class or whatever, where everyone's got souped up cars and you're not just racing, you're not racing people who are just starting out. So that'd be one of my recommendations. Obviously, having more players so that that's actually necessary would help too, but the only way to do that is for people to, you know, watch these kind of videos and decide that they want to give the game a try and maybe even like it. So we got a couple more cars making pits because they did pit too early. So we got back up into sixth place already. Last lap here. See if we can't hold on to some of these positions. Our tires starting to get a low, our guys being very non-aggressive. So it looks like we're going to finish 7th. Not as good as I would have hoped, because I do feel we could have done better, but a bunch of people stopping right in front of us and holding us up, and our guy not having enough awareness to go around, plus the issue with the tires, our guy being a little passive on the turns because he didn't want to spin out, cost us a few positions. I really think we could have been top 5, maybe even a little higher if things would have went our way, but, you know, that happens. Doesn't always go your way. We did have a best zone time though, 27.22 seconds in zone 3, so that's going to get us a medal and a few extra bucks. Wow, some of these people have 22 second pit times. Oh, that's probably because they pit twice. Yeah, that's why. So actually, that's really not a bad time because that means they only spent about 11 seconds in the pits, which killed ours. We got 3 medals. Really don't know what crowd pleaser is or go green, but hey, I'll take the extra money and experience points. Alright, we'll go ahead and get one more race in and see if we can't perform a little bit better. We do have points to spend. Really wish I knew what each of these were. I'm sure this is handling. I really don't know what this is. Maybe this is the awareness stat, so that he has awareness to get around people. I really don't know. As bad as our pit times are, you know, even if we were able to cut 2 or 3 seconds off, that really is not going to make that big of a difference for us right now. At least until we start pitting like twice, then that would make a big difference. But let's go ahead and get 1 star of the clock, and then we'll focus on the other guys here. Yeah, there's nothing to see what that is. Alright, no scholarship offers. Looks like we completed the bonus objectives for all of our things. Now we just need to put in the required amount of races. Probably expect about maybe 12 to 15,000 worth of sponsorship dollars here on the side. That'd be enough for an upgrade. So once we get, we only need. Looks like 5 more races for these guys and 9 more for these, so still a while, but I think by the time we finish that off, we'll probably have a couple upgrades done to the car and be competing a little bit better. So let's go ahead and get in the next race, get one more in, and call it a night with this video. Alright, we're going to want to go hard. There's a lot of straightaways here, which means we're going to want the speed over the cornering. I'm not sure if this is a night race or if weather conditions are just cool because it's going to rain. That looks like a really low temperature, so I'm guessing it's probably a night race. I've noticed that the daytime temperatures are in the 20s, so something maybe to consider later once we upgrade our crew a little bit. Start with less fuel. Doing that, we'll have to pit twice, but it'll make sure that our tires are fresh for the entire race, and we have a lighter car to start the race, so that maybe we can get a little bit of a lead. It looks like we have raced this one before. It's probably the first race that we did. I'm not sure if this is morning or night. Got a little bit of sun back there. Alright, so we're going to be starting 9. see a lot of people wrecking on those last two turns there. We got some speed boost now. I think this next straightaway would be a good time to use it. So it is getting warmer, which means it's probably dawn. So we're going to be hitting next lap. And we'll be more than good for the rest of the race, both tires and fuel, it looks like. Getting warmer, which is going to affect our tires, but it's still a pretty cool speed, so we'll be fine. Alright guys, quick stop, let's go. Tires are changed, gas is full, let's go. 11 seconds, well, 12 pretty much. A lot better than what we've been getting. Alright. I'm not sure why the guy gets all squirrely there. it's going to be cooling off here a little bit, which means our tires are pretty much going to be safe. Oops. Wow. Alright, final lap. Holding on for 7. Seems to be fairly decent. We're working our way up to the top here. You know, it's just a matter of getting some money upgrading the car, the more skill points upgrading our drivers. So, and once we do that, we'll be doing a lot better. We'll get back to the garage here and work on wrapping up this video. So we had one medal, it was the Go Green, pretty much like always. And a little bit of money and some XP. Still not enough XP to upgrade anything or money to upgrade anything, so. But we got 3 races in on this video. Gonna go ahead and wrap it up here. Thank you for watching. This was episode 3 of Trackday Manager by Arctic Hazard Game Studio. Thank you for watching.